obviously you're a gifted actress. You have another gift, which I was not aware of, but thanks to social media, you have shared it with the world.
Listen.
You're an artist of sorts. This is a photo you put on social media, and look at, that's just such...
It's not hard. I mean, it's not hard. It's not hard in the sense it's not difficult.
Oh, wow. Like, so are you really saying anyone could do this, Kate? Because
really?
Don't sell yourself short.
You know, you do have to have an eye, and you do have to obviously have the desire to do it.
Right.
Which I have in spades.
Yeah, because this is not a one-off photo.
No, it's not. I do that quite a lot.
Yeah. You, in fact, sent us 30 photos today. And I want to point out, because a lot of people, I will say, like, bananas, apples, that's the obvious one.
Always funny.
But you can do it, I mean...
Oh, hey, yes.
Your range.
Well...
No, I want to ask, because there's a series you sent that are all outside the same one. Looks like a hotel room door.
Listen, there was a sense that it's a slightly bordering into bullying, is what we did.
Oh, whose hotel room door is this?
It was a very, very nice actor called Jim Sturgis. That's a thin one.
I hate this. Yeah. Like, that one makes me sad.
That's never popular with anyone.
No. Because nothing would be worse than that girth and that length.
That's what we call packing a chive.
Yeah. Is that a British term, or is that sort of universal?
I think it might be British.
So this is a co-star of yours, and then every day he would just wake up and have...
It was like love bombing. I think it strayed into bullying, but I felt very... positive about it.
Every time you did it, you felt... Now, when you go into grocery stores, is there a panic in the produce section?
No, but I do. I have to know what I'm getting. I could be there all day. Do you know what I mean?
Right, of course.
There's so much.
Yeah, it's like
veg available to make into a cock and
Picasso going into a paint store. You know, you're just there.
Yes.
And you've gotten your obsession with this part of the male body has gotten you in trouble.
I haven't got an obsession with that part of the male body. I like arranging fruit and veg into the. I like the fruit version. It's not like I'm obsessed with just all people's.
Okay, gotcha. Penis. This seems like a very thin distinction between what you're doing and what I'm saying you're doing.
It's funny if it's made out of a couple of tomatoes. It's not always funny in real life. It's always funny if it's vegetables and fruit.
Well, it depends. Yeah, you're right.
I mean,
I guess I should be happy that it's not always funny.
Imagine how excited you are when you get to your hotel room and they've got lychees.
Yeah.
They're all hairy as well. So
oh, my God.
Really...
So when Kate Beckinsale sees a lychee, she just must lose her mind.
Oh, you can imagine foaming at the mouth. So
exciting. But you've gotten your daughter in trouble with this.
I did one. I was just doodling one, and I didn't realize.
Just doodling in case.
It's sort of become like my sign. It's like my bat sign.
Okay, gotcha.
People know I've been there if their fruit bowl's been rearranged, that sort of thing. And I had four brothers growing up. It was
okay. Gotcha. Understood.
So anyway, so I think I had sort of been on the phone and kind of doodled one, but it was on her homework and she was in the sixth grade, so she got in trouble for it.
And when her teacher found it, what did she say?
She said, "Look, Lily, that's not appropriate." And Lily went, "Look, I don't even know what to..." It was my mother.
And then, do you get called in and have to explain yourself?
No, luckily no, but they don't look at you in the eye. You know, they think that's a terrible person, and quite rightly. I mean, rightly so. That's a terrible thing to do.
That's a terrible thing to do. Yeah. Yeah.